वंदेहं शिखरं सृजुत पदकमलं श्रीगुरुं विष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं शाग्रजातं सगण रघुनाथमितं तं सजीवं सहादैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्री राधा कृष्ण पादं सगण ललिता विशाखान्वितांश्च भज श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभुनितानंद श्रीअद्वैत गदाधर शिवशदि गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। ऑल ग्लोरीज टू श्री गुरु एंड गौरांग, ऑल ग्लोरीज टू श्री गुरु परंपरा, ऑल ग्लोरीज टू श्री भक्तिविनोद ठाकुर, All glories to Sri Jaiva Dharma, All glories to Hare Krishna Mahamantra Sankirtan, All glories to assembled devotees, All glories, All glories, All glories. Here really too hot. I think this heart today may be more than 40. More than 40. Anyway, there is questions. Questions from Sarveshwari Devi Dasi. I heard that Krishna playing 8 notes in his flute control all the universes. Can you tell us about this pastime? Anyway, 8 note, you know this finger, just we can show you this. So 8 finger, 8 note, Krishna is playing flute. So according as I heard from our previous teachers, first note, when tune coming from first note of Krishna's flute, that heart thus hitting to the ear of Brahma. Pratham Ramdhani Gane Bhangaya Brahmaradha. Brahma's meditation broke. So Brahma eagerly waiting to see Krishna and get his order. Whatever Lord says, Brahma is following. First, now how this entire world, was only this material world was there, but no living entities. How it appeared. Brahma got the order from Lord, create the living entities. Three explanation. Jnanam paramagnyanme jadabhijnana samannita. This is the word of Krishna, Lord. And it is Brahma listening. Jnanam paramagnyanme jadabhijnana samannitam sarahasyam tadaganchan grihano gaditangamaya javanaham jatavabo yadarupakuna karamakaha tathaiva tatta vikyanamastu te madanagraha. That's why more four slokas is there. Ahom eva shame bhagri nannat jat sat sat param vashyadam jadecho jobo shishyati shashyam prityartam jat pratyetana pratyeta chatmani tadvidyat manomayam jathabhasa jathatama jathamahanti bhutani bhuteshu charapachashmano prabhishtana prabhishtani तथा तेषु नातिवश्यम् एतावदेव जिज्ञासं तत्त्वजिज्ञासनदमन् अन्मयो व्यतिरेकभ्यं यत्सत्सर्वत्रौ सर्वदा एतन्मतं समाधिष्ट परो मे न समाधिना भवन् कल्पविकल्पेषु न विमच्छति करीचि. फास्ट् This is the instruction Brahma God for the entire knowledge of universes. So anyway, these Brahma's topics we can talk later in another class. But it will take maybe 8 days because essence of This is called Srimad Bhagavatam Chatushloki. Means essence of entire Srimad Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavatam 18,000 slok, 12 canto, total 345 chapters. And that is essence. That means you can imagine how big is that content. So, second note, eighth note, Patham randhe rigane bhangaya brahmaradhan Ditya randhe jamuna ujaya. When tune coming from the second note of Krishna's flute, that is hitting the ear of Jamuna Devi, Jamraja's sister, Kalindi Devi. Jamuna Devi also, one wife of Krishna. So anyway, this is the second note hitting that here Jamuna Ujai. Ujai means Jamuna have waves. Why? Because such a sweet tune hitting in the ear of Jamuna Devi. Jamuna Devi in river form, he should go from north to south. So Jamuna Devi just go ahead two steps and coming back one. Joya go ahead two steps because she want to listen more the sweet tune of Krishna. So Jamuna Ujai in that way, Jamuna's waves. Jamuna doesn't want to go, or she have to go. In that way, waves appear. Third note means when tune coming from, coming out from the third note of Krishna's flute, then it is hitting the Vayudeva. Vayudeva means God of air. Titiya randhe pavanero goti hata hai. Pavandev means Vayudeva. Vayudeva means God of air. Goti rato means Vayudeva's speed becomes slow. You know, Vrindavan have one place named Dhir Shamir. Dhir means slow. Shamir means air. So, Pavanero Goti Hato. Third note, it is hitting the air of Vayudeva and becomes slow. Fourth note. Chaturtha Randher Gane Baje Brajo Narir Prane. Na. Chaturtha Randher Sure Aponese Dhenu Fire Trinamukhe Urdhva Pichadai. Fourth note of Krishna's flute. When fourth note of Krishna's flute, the tune coming from the fourth note of Krishna flute, it is hitting the ear of all the cows. So they are such a blissful. They are keeping grasses because in the cow herding time, 900,000 cows Krishna keeping with him. You can understand, 9 cow make us crazy and Krishna keep 900,000 cows. So he is controlling entire cows through her flute, fourth note. Fourth note, tune coming from the Krishna, fourth note of Krishna's flute, it is hitting the ear of cows. And what they say? Trinamukhe urdhva pichadai. Trinamukhe means grass. Mukhe means keeping their jaw on the grass. They are not chewing. You know, when they're chewing, then it is not properly, you are not able to hear properly. Therefore, all the cows in the cowherd fields, the grass they are keeping in the jawbone, and out of leash they are keeping the tail above of the body and running towards Krishna. Fifth note, Panchama Randher Gane Baje Brajo Narir Prane Elothelo Pagalini Prane. Fifth note of Krishna's flute, and tune coming from that fifth note, it is hitting the ear of all Brajagopis. They become crazy. Now to attend the Raso dance, So all Vrajagopis become crazy. By Shri Radharani, Radharani such a crazy. So Radharani wants to meet. There is a huge explanation on song, but I don't have time to explain that song. What is written by Narottam Thakur. Sixth note, it is also hitting the ear of stone, you know. Stone become melting. You may think a stone is have no life, right? Stone also have life. Therefore, when you do concrete on the roof, we are breaking the stone. First we are killing the stone. Even I saw my spirit, my grandmother, you know, one type of soul, you know, young, even as baby time, when I was a baby, when I saw there so many babies in our village, there is a stone. If you put lemon juice on the stone, that stone can walk, move. That I have seen. Stone has life. Proof, Charan Pahadi if you go, come upon. Then we can see Bhojanthali, Jammabon, all those places still, that stone melted. So melting that signage there. So Krishna's flute, it is hitting the ear of all stone. And Galaya Shila means stone started to melt. And seventh note, first note, I missed it. Sixth note, this is hitting the air of all six seasons. Six seasons. You know, this maybe we have only four seasons in Australia. But actually in India, six seasons. Nowadays, due to influence of age of deception, Kali, that's not coming properly, but actually it is coming. It has the six seasons. The season like this, summer, monsoon, autumn, late autumn, spring and winter. That six season. Ekatre Devoy, they become together and are moving. Let us explain. This explanation we have from our previous teachers. Seventh note, what I explained, this stone melted. Seventh note. Eighth note, the tune, it is hitting the ear of Radhe. Because it is speaking, it is singing. Radhe, Gaye Radhe Tobonam. Eighth note, the tune is telling Radhe, Radhe, Radhe. In that way, Radharani control means entire energy control. Pleasure-based potency control. Anyway, these are the eight note, Krishna's flute. It worked like this way. Question from Gauranam Das. Gauranam Das, Hare Krishna Maharaj Dandavad. When Mahaprabhu said, one who chant Harinam once in a Vaishnava, once is a Vaishnava, what quality of name is the referring to? Aparado, Avash, Shuddha. No, Shuddha. Mahaprabhu, whenever he say, once in a day, chant, that person we have to consider he is a Vaishnava, that is Shuddha now. Shuddha means pure name. No. Aparad means not inattentively chant. When you are chanting inattentively, that is Aparad. Avas means we are not attentive, also we are not thinking about Krishna. And not attentive, not focusing any material, or not focusing with chanting Hari Nam. Just simply chanting. This is called Avas, semblance of Holy Name. And Shuddha means fully absorbed, not attentively think about Radha Krishna. Maybe he is in some temple altar, he is in holy, he is in transcendental abode under the wistful fig tree, that stage. Shuddha now, yes. At which stage does Shuddha Naam first manifest? Shuddha Naam manifest that time when you become free from all type of unwanted mundane desire. Unwanted mundane desire. Chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra, gradually curing all our unwanted mundane desire. Anartha. Therefore Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, Chitta Shuddhi Sarva Bhakti Sadhana Udgam. Means, whenever you chanting, Chitta Shuddhi. Means, mind, intelligence, everything become pure. Never think any kind of, we can say, false ego. Never feel in the trap of false ego. Never running behind material name, fame, distinction, recognition, desire. If someone say anything which is connected with us, with me, which is really someone insulting us, we feel that is blessings of Krishna. I am in this, my karma, Lord wants to cure. My karma's concept, man, Lord wants to cure, therefore that person insulting me. And Lord become happy when I feel insulted. So we become happy also. So Shuddha Naam, when this mind status is in this stage, not running behind name, fame, pratishtha, jaws, that time Shuddha Naam will manifest in our. There is a symptom Shuddha Naam manifesting. At which stage does Shuddha Naam become constant and completely cure our all unwanted mundane desire, and our mind always under the shelter of our previous teachers, means parampara, that time. And there is no question of independent nature. That time we can see that is the Shuddha Naam. Shuddha Naam will constantly can chant. That time we are able to chant Shuddha Naam constantly. I hope Guranam Prabhu you understand my points, you know. I don't think so, no one sending any message. Yeah, now I have to go to the Jaiva Dharma. Yes, last week we started the Jaiva Dharma. Jaiva means living entities, Jiva. Dharma means what is eternal, natural function of our soul. Means what is the eternal, natural function of our soul? or means jiva soul. That is called jiva dharma. So there is a conversation between Sannyasi Thakur, who previously was Mayavadi Sannyasi. He liked Navadvip Vaishnava's culture, nature, and Mayavadi Sannyasis. He liked, why? Because very nice logical explanation. So when he heard Jeev like an atom, Anu, then he, and also he heard Jeev's dharma, eternal, absolute, and pure. So his question appeared, if Jeev is atom, tiny, anu, how his dharma become eternal and absolute and pure? That is the first question he asked to that Paramahansa Babaji. The second question he asked, if dharma based on the structure of jiva, how then you can see jiva? And if dharma based on the structure of jiva, then that dharma, how it become eternal? Because Jeev's body is not eternal. So in this regard, there is, as Paramahansa Babaji says, this Jeev, although his atom, tiny, but his dharma means, religiosity, purno, absolute, shuddho sunata. Again he said like this. Jeev, anu, which is one, this is size of that jeev. But when he become come on contact, like fire, he just give explanation, fire spark, it's tiny, but when it touch with ignitable stove, it become big fire. So anyway, so Jibir, Jeev, living entities, how his dharma become eternal, please listen carefully. Sannyasi Thakur says, and Paramahansa Babaji says, Premi Jeever Nitya Dharma. Prem means love. What is the definition of love? Divine love means there is no expectation. Just when we do everything for Lord's satisfaction, without any expectation, then we can say it is love. Nitya kana, it is. Yeah, love, prem. Outwardly, if you look, our body is material, and outwardly we can say jada tito, jeev ajada. Ajada means जीव हैज लाइफ एंड इट इज बियॉन्ड ऑफ ऑल बियॉन्ड मटेरियल मैंने बियॉन्ड ऑफ जड़ातीत मीन्स बियॉन्ड ऑफ मटेरियल एक्चुअली इज ट्रांसेंडेंटल कैन से चैतन्य घटम ही हैज कॉन्शियस हिज स्ट्रक्चर मेड विथ कॉन्शियसनेस सो व्हेन फॉर्म ऑफ जीवो द टाइनी एटम फॉर्म when it is there with us, with the body, body moving. Otherwise, body is not possible to move. Then he says, Krishna Dasai Shri Prem Bimal Prem. That Prem will appear, when we realize, when we become servant of Lord Krishna. Krishna Dasai means servant. When we feel I am servant of Krishna, That is called Bimal Prem, symptom of Bimal Prem. Start. Atev Krishna Das Sharup Premi Jive Sharup Dharma. Therefore, Krishna Das has, it is like an eternal identity of all living beings. Then, the Paramahansa Babaji says, In this regard, means the question based on the question. There's two conditions in amongst the jiva. One is Shuddha Avastha and Baddha Avastha. Shuddha means pure. Baddha means materially bound condition. Materially bound condition. Actually, we are chanting. To get rid from the materially bound condition. If you look our previous teachers praying, whenever we are chanting Hari, then our previous teacher says, Hey Hari, Machittam Hitva, Bhava Bandhanam is materially bound condition. So, this is all your materially bound condition. You can see that. I can give an example. All of you are sitting now, I think Melbourne and Australia, maybe 7:30 to 8 o'clock, 8 p.m. Maybe all of you are going to sleep because tomorrow you have to go for work. Maybe now at lockdown you have to sit in the home. But anyway, just like a sleeping, midnight, deep sleep. All of a sudden, your friend called you, that near to your home, there is a miracle happening. What miracle? From the Mother Earth, coming out big piece of diamond, 2,000 carat, 3,000 carat diamond. An Australian government, they say, anyway, night time you are not able to control. People can gather their diamond, but morning, you are feeling so much sleepy. Will you sleep or leave? Anyhow, you have to prepare yourself, go out. Even in the middle of the Harikatha, means like Krishna appear in the altar and give him darshan and telling everyone, hey, oh my bhakta vrindmana, oh my devotees, just giving you darshan. Middle of the darshan, such message came. Will you sit for see Krishna? Because Krishna, you know, Krishna will disappear after half an hour. Will you sit for Krishna and ignore that news? Or will you go for getting the diamond and ignore Krishna? You know, there is a you know, few, maybe one or two amongst the 1 million human, you can find, they will ignore. The rest, I'm sure everybody goes over there to collect that diamond. They are always, we are always thinking intellectually. Okay, let me get the diamond and we can do Krishna Seva. For the service of Krishna, we can leave Krishna Darshan. Such type of logic we can put and go. This is the call Baddha Avastha, materially bound condition. Who has such type of understanding to go, they are called materially bound condition. Shuddha Avastha, pure stage means who has understanding in mind, who is thinking around the world, everything is material. But originally we are transcendental conscious. So we have to ignore all the material things. And in that way they can ignore the news of the diamond. Diamond news they will ignore, and they will release the beautiful form of Radha Krishna coming in the altar and speaking with us. So, Shuddha Avastha, Baddha Avastha. I think you understand what I want. This analogy, what I said. This is not there in Jaiva Dharma, but just for our understanding. Shuddha Avastha and Baddha Avastha. Shuddha means pure, Baddha means bound condition. Shuddha Avastha is Jeev Keval Chinmay. Shuddha Avastha means pure condition, stage. Pure mean pure stage, Jeev always Chinmay, transcendental. They always thinking about transcendental abode. They are each Supreme Lord is allowing us to serve Him. So we have to get the opportunity. But Baddha Avastha means condition, materially bound condition. They are always thinking of, they are keeping relation with material things. But Shuddha Avastha, there is no any kind of material connection. He look all the living being, they are servant of Supreme Lord. Therefore they are always respecting everyone. They are not blaspheming. Their tendency not to blaspheme anyone, their tendency not to ignore, not to put in trouble, not create any harmful condition for anyone. Therefore, Shuddha Jeev we call Sadhu, because Sadhu means they are always searching eternity, always connected with eternity. But nowadays Sadhu's definition is wrong, it's actually difference. Our understanding about Sadhu is difference, because we know Sadhu means who is wearing saffron, who is giving katha, means divine katha. But nowadays divine katha you can see so many big speaker. In India I saw, they are very famous speaker, but they are promoting Muslimism, Muslim faith. subtle manner. It's very difficult to realize for general people. But nowadays also I have seen few speakers openly they are praying Muslim, no, Allah, they are chanting the name of Allah on the Vyasashram, very same, but what to do? Kali Yuga, dharma going to turn like a business. Yeah, sadhu become businessman. It is Srimad Bhagavatam 12th canto, 3rd chapter. If you look, then you can see there is the explanation. Kali Yuga dharma. Actually, sannyasi become businessman. Renounced person become businessman. Householder, they will depend on the renounced person. But before it was opposite. Sannyasi will beg, but renounced people will beg from householder. Householder will give them donation. Then they will, then sadhu will survive. But now, gradually you can see sadhu become businessman, katha business, contact 15 lakh, contact 1 crore, 10 million rupees, one katha means one session of katha. But which katha is not based on shastra, his katha is a speech based on people's what they want to listen, based on that. So therefore, I'm just telling this, nowadays, sadhu's definition turning to another direction. But real sadhu, they're always searching eternity. So in this age, in order to search eternity, this age prescribed to chant Hari Nam. Harir Nama, Harir Nama, Harir Nama, Iva Kevalam. Kalau Nasti, Nasti. Kalu means Kali Yuga. This is age of deception, Kali Yuga. There is only one way to chant Hari Nam and respect everyone and give due respect to everyone. Become free from all material recognition, designation, promotion, free from all that, and become humble and tolerance, keeping unbelievable manner tolerance. Then we can see that is the symptom. He is sadhu. No tendency to take revenge. No, the sadhu never become harmful to anybody. Anyway, the suddha vasata jiva anu padartho. When living entities become suddha, means real form of living entities. Means just tiny soul, atom form. Jiva anu padartho, suddha vasata means then pure condition, jeev always tiny atom. So anutta prajukta jeev avasthantar prapti sambhavana. They are always transforming from anutta. Anutta means tiny atom form of real jeeva. Avasthantar, according to the situation, they are transcending. Brihat Chaitanya Sarup Krishna Samavato Avasthantar Nai. Brihat Chaitanya Sarup. Brihat Chaitanya means Vibhu, means huge. Vibhu means who is Krishna. Naturally, He is not changing. He always eternal. His form is eternal. His devotion eternal. Which connected with him closely all the eternal. Therefore, we want to be devotee of Krishna. We want to be eternally connected with Krishna. And whenever we have desire to be connected with Krishna, that is called our best endeavor to establish our real identity. Tini vastuto brihat, you know, Krishna. Actually, brihat means huge, purno, absolute, shuddha, pure, asanatan, eternal. Huge, absolute, pure, and eternal. This is Krishna. Jeev vastuto anu, jeev means living entities. Anu, like a tiny atom, khando, divided. Asuddho, impure, asuddho hiva yoga. But in certain condition, they become also asuddho. They are eligible to be asuddho. Arbachin means, they are also forgetful. Their real condition is forgetful. Kintu dharmata, ji brihat, akhanda, Shuddha Sanatan. But if we look his eternal condition, he is Brihat, Ji Brihat Akhanda. Akhanda means non-dependent. He is not Akhanda. Akhanda means divided. He is always connected. Brihat, Ji Brihat Akhanda means when he connected with Supreme Lord Krishna, then become akhanda, means no deviation, shuddha, pure, and sanatan. Jeev jatakkhan shuddha, tatakkhani tadha sadharmer vimal paricha. When living entities become pure, how long he become pure, means devotionally advanced, connected to his Lord, then sadharma vimal parichaya. Then his sadharma means his eternal servant of Krishna. That is his identity and pure identity. That is pure identity. Jeev takhon maya sambandha asuddho. Jeev jakhon maya sambandha asuddho, takhon iti sadhana vikar prajukta asuddho. When jeev trapped with illusion, then he become impure. And he forget his real identity. And he intoxicated and become intoxicated abhishuddho. Means impure, anasrita, no shelter, and dukkha, sukha-dukkha pishta, and sometimes semblance of happiness, sometimes full of distress. Pishta, just like in that cycle is moving. That no, you know that cycle is this birth and death, happiness and distress cycle. That we are moving with so many type of bodies, living entities. Sometime we are aquatic form, sometime we are tree plant form, a reptile form, bird form, animal form, and human form. Always we are moving. Sometimes we are in hell, sometimes on heaven, sometimes the earth, different in 14 planetary system, moving around that. Sometimes we become goddess, devi, Devata and God, sometimes a human, in that way moving. Jivar Krishna Dasya Vishmiti Haivar Samsar Goti Asitana. As soon as he become, he forget that he is their servant of Krishna, then he got attachment with this material world. জীব যতক্ষণ শুদ্ধ থাকে ততক্ষণই তার স্বধর্মের অভিমান জীব হোয়েন হি বিকাম শুদ্ধ মিন্স হোয়েন হি ইজ এবল টু রিমেম্বার হি ইজ ইটার্নাল সার্ভেন্ট অফ কৃষ্ণ দেন হি ফিল আই অ্যাম সার্ভেন্ট অফ কৃষ্ণ ইউ ক্যান সি পিওর ডিভোটি দে ডোন্ট ফিল ফিয়ার দে ডোন্ট ফিল শেম টু কিপ নেক বিট অ্যান্ড ফর তিলক অন দেয়ার ফরহেড. You know, other people, they are criticizing us. Hey, what is this? But we feel proud. Although I am not pure, but, you know, in mind, we feel I become fortunate that I am able to realize the Krishna's devotion. I feel fortunate. Because I get connection with my spiritual master, who giving me connection with Supreme Lord. I feel always indebted towards our previous teacher, Parampara, my spiritual master, His Divine Grace, Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Thakur. I feel indebted. I feel indebted with Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta. Why? Because he sent my spiritual master to all of us. We feel indebted to Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Why? Because he composed so many books and gave us so many books and gave us such a great guru, Bhakti Siddhanta Thakur. That we feel. Therefore, if someone give me the opportunity, okay, Maharaj, I can give you $1 billion, leave all your ashram and come to my home, I feel happy to be in our Gurudev ashram. I may not feel happy to get the $1 billion. Still I feel like that, but I don't know. Reality, when appears such things, what is going to happen in my mind? Maya samanda shuddha hoile, sei abhiman sankuchita hoiya, bhinna bhinna akar dharan kare. When we are really feeling Krishna das and we feel proud of that, but when we get connection with illusion, and we become impure, and that abhiman, that proud, gradually sankochito. Sankochito means sotta, and bhinna bhinna kala, and different form it takes. It takes a different form. The pure become pure, become sotta, pure because sankochito means is synchronized and divided with different form. Maya samanda jivir shuddha sarup linga asthula deva apritha hai. As soon as we connected with Maya illusion, jiv, the real form of jiv, linga deva asthula deva. Linga deva means that, no, I am different type of designation. Suladeva means this body. Linga deho covered by with this thula deho. Abhrita means covered. Takhon linga sharire ekta prithak abhiman udoy hoy. The linga sharire, this material body, one pride appeared. অভিমান আমার স্থূল দেহের অভিমানের সহিত মিশ্রিত হইয়া দ্যাট অ্যান্ড ফ্রাইড অর ইগো মিক্সিং উইথ দিস ফিজিক্যাল ফর্ম অ্যান্ড অ্যাপিয়ার ওয়ান মোর থার্ড অভিমান অ্যাপিয়ার ওয়ান মোর অভিমান মিনস ফ্রাইড দিস থার্ড অভিমান থার্ড ফ্রাইড অ্যাপিয়ার অরিজিনাল ইন দ্যাট ওয়ার ডিভাইডেড নো লিঙ্গ শরীর মিনস দিস বডি উইথ ডিফারেন্ট ডিফারেন্ট ডেজিগনেশন বডি অ্যাপিয়ার ইন দ্য স্থূল দেহ মিনস দিস ফিজিক্যাল ফর্ম অ্যান্ড দেন অভিমান ইগো ইজ এক্সপ্যান্ডিং দেন হোয়েন দ্য মিক্স লিঙ্গ শরীর অভিমান অ্যান্ড স্থূল দেহ অভিমান mixing together appear one more ego this is third ego shuddha sharire jit kebol krishna das when our body become pure means body chanting pure name is only their designation they always say I am servant of krishna they never say anything I am father of that person, mother of that person. I am in this different type of designation like a doctor, lawyer, engineer, such type of, no, not. Only I am servant of Krishna. Linga sharire jeev apanake sakarma phaler bhokta. When we are suffering with such linga sharire, means our different designation. Sakarma phala bhakta means we are enjoying the benefit of our karma, bhokta. Sakarma karma's benefit, good karma giving you enjoyment. অর্থাৎ ভোগ কর্তা বলে আমাকে গুড কর্ম গিভিং গুড রেজাল্ট মিন্স মেটেরিয়াল বেনিফিট মেটেরিয়াল কমফর্টেবল লাইফ সো হি ইজ থিঙ্কিং আই অ্যাম দ্য কর্তা লাইক ইফ ইউ হ্যাভ $10 billion অ্যান্ড ইউ হ্যাভ সেভারাল হাউসেস ইন মন্ট্রিয়াল সিডনি দেন ইউ ক্যান সি দিস ইজ মাই প্রপার্টি If I want to go and stay and ask you, can I have one of your house? You will definitely say, although you have enough, but you will definitely say, no, go. If I sell it, I can have money, this is my property. This is sakarma phala bhakta, this is, I have to enjoy that house. Then, তখন কৃষ্ণদাসের অভিমান লিঙ্গ দেহাভিমানের দ্বারা আবৃত হইয়া থাকে দিস ডেজিগনেশন হাউস অফ ওনার অফ দিস সো মেনি হাউসেস ইউ আর গুড অ্যাক্টর ইউ আর গেটিং লট অফ মানি টু শোয়িং দিস অ্যাক্ট ইউ নো দিস মুভি অ্যাক্টর দ্যার এক্সট্রিমলি রিচ সো দিস They become puffed up. I am an actor. I have so much $1 million or $1 billion. So that ego taking place and then Krishna Das finish. Servant of Krishna, that relation, you forget. Our sthul deho labh kariya when You know this, sthula means this body, physical body. For physical body, if they born in Brahmin family, they say, I am a Brahmin. If you become king, I am a king. A poor, I am a Doridra, I am in distress. I am covered with different diseases. I am wife, I am husband of that woman, etc. Such type of designation we are establishing when we have this body, physical body. The physical body covered linga deho, different designation, designation different designation, linga deho covered with our that real paricha, real Ganesh, this Shuddha paricha, Shuddha sarva, pure condition. The pure is there, but it's covered with different type of layer, different feeling. But originally, jeev always pure, but covered like an inasi. You can see always we are hating sinful activities, bad karmas activities. But we are not hating any person. If people have a real understanding about our designation, all we are as eternal servant of Krishna, all we are coming from Krishna, they never hate any living entities. Therefore Vaishnava never killed any animals. Whatever food we are eating, that is also living entities, but according to the order of Lord, we are offering to Lord that food which is prescribed by Lord. Flour, fruits, patram, pushpam, phalam, toyam, flour, fruits, leaves, water, milk, such we are offering to Lord. That means, theme is this, Lord's, all living entities coming from Lord, we are offering, although they are living entities, we are offering to Lord, offering them to Lord, and Lord delivered them. Instead of they become angry on us, when Lord delivered them, they become happy. They feel indebted. I can give an example that suppose you slap me. Well, I am doing something wrong, you slap me, 2-3 slap, very heavy. Then they pull me for judgment, because I am doing something wrong, that wrong activities. He pull me, because he was pure devotee, he pull me towards Lord for judgment. What do you feel? Oh, this Prabhu is very merciful. He may be slap, but he pulling me to Lord, such a beautiful form of Lord. Then I feel indebted for that. So here also, the sadhu means who is chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, they are going door to door and giving discourses from Shastra, not from the mind concoction. Purpose, the main purpose to make them understand you are pure, but your lingo, your egos, linga sarir means you are purush, you are male, you are female, you are doctor, whatever designation you have, you are just covering that. And then the linga sarir is covered with thul sarir, means physical form. and gradually physical body's connection, you know, husband, wife, which caste, that in that way they are giving their paricha, means their designation. Anyway, so it's very difficult and touchy, but in the first 2-3 chapter like this, after that I think you'll enjoy Jaiva Dharma, because that, after the story wise writing there, but his tattva, you know, truth is there. You have to understand the tattva. What is your designation? How it become pure? How it involved with the Maya? How we act when we trap in Maya? How we act? Such type of explanation here, first 2-3 chapter like this. After that, I think you feel enjoy. Also, I feel enjoy. Hare Krishna. Thank you very much for all of your attention. And if you want me to speak on the, instead of line wise reading, you want me to just synopsis of each chapter, then I can do that. That will, you can enjoy that type of, because you know Bengali writing, so many repetition there. You may feel bored because you are an English speaking person. You don't want to listen twice and one thing, right? Repetition you don't want. So let me know what you want. You want to listen the synopsis, I can do that. And if you want to listen only the word by word, line wise reading, how I am reading, I can do that also. And also if I find one English book that I can read, I think that you can do that sitting in the home, you can do that. I think better for us to reading or synopsis, reading line-wise, Bengali, original language, how Bhaktivinoda Thakur wrote, and after that, whatever my talent allow, I will try to explain you and all by line. Please let me know your opinion about it. And then I will come again next Monday and Tuesday. Monday Hindi and Tuesday English, I think. Hare Krishna.